delay on this rain clearing up is about 10 minutes, so just keep your concentration out there, you're doing well.
Welcome to the Miami International Autodrome, home of the Miami Grand Prix. This exciting track circumnavigates the Hard Rock Stadium, home to the National Football League outfit, the Miami Dolphins. Sitting at the southeastern coast of Florida, the Miami International Autodrome has 19 corners and 3.36 miles of racing. It's a circuit designed to encourage close racing while meeting the highest safety standards. Either way, I'm sure it's one that will please the fans. Let's run you through the driver grid order for today's exciting race. Lando Norris will lead us away from pole position, and Robert Schwartzman completes the front row. Looking at the rest of today's grid, we have Verstappen, Oscar Piastri, Charles Leclerc, and Gasly, Bottas, Sainz, Perez, and Daniel Tictum, Tsunoda, Joe, George Russell, and Albon, Ocon, Vettel, Lance Stroll, and more. Mick Schumacher and Nicholas Latifi. It's almost time for the lights to go out, so let's head down to the track where preparations are underway. A warm welcome to Anthony Davidson, who's beside me in the commentary box today. Let's have a chat about McLaren. We have a number of changes to the aerodynamic regulations this year, and the signs haven't looked good for them so far in terms of getting to grips with those changes.
There are a few downcast looks within the team this weekend. I think they've been hit fairly hard by the new regs, but this is only the first step down a long road of development, and even if they don't maximise their points today, there are plenty more up for grabs this season.
I know this is your home Grand Prix, but treat it like any other race. Let's not make any unnecessary risks. Is good, but we need to learn the gears, so go into each one when you can. We're going to need some work on the brakes, so put some energy into them and warm the tyres as well, please. No threat of rain for the time being, conditions look good. Okay, we're monitoring somewhere on the internal combustion engine. Be aware that we're going to start to see a loss of power. And that's the end of the race. We'll see you in Parc Fermé.
They've done it then, a truly magnificent win here at the Miami International Autodrome. So, Anthony, what made the difference out there today?
I'd say it was down once again to good consistent driving, nailing the corners, working to the track conditions and perfecting the team's strategies. They got all of these things right today and the results speak for themselves.
Our winning drivers are on their way to the podium right now. It's been a fantastic race for McLaren, that's for sure. And no doubt, they'll be celebrating tonight. Who would you say is a contender for driver of the day?
I have to give it to Moore. They demonstrated a very delicate touch in close proximity to other cars, as well as showing a lot of maturity and patience in difficult situations.
Let's move on to the constructors. McLaren continue to increase their gap at the top. After an event like that, who knows what the sport has in store for us next time out. Be sure to join us once again as we continue to bring you all the excitement of Formula One.
Our new parts have completed without issue. They'll be on the car ready for the next race weekend. A reporter has asked to interview you. The department wants me to pass on their thanks for helping out. Okay, we've had the new parts come through the fabrication process. We'll have them with us for the next Grand Prix. We had a major issue on the production line earlier this week, so the entire development package for the weekend has failed. Any redevelopments will need to be ordered from the R&D screen.